Very good morning, all of you. See, in the last lecture, we have discussed about the combustion, okay? Some combustible substance, non-combustible substance, types of combustion. So, in types of combustion, we have done the study that is the first type of combustion is a rapid combustion, second one is a spontaneous combustion, and third one it is an explosion, okay? So, we have discussed in a previous lecture. So, now today, what we are going to need? Now you everyone know about the combustion means what, okay? So there are some specific conditions are very essential for the combustion process. So today we will going to learn in a detail about the conditions necessary for the combustion. Okay, so now the first condition is a combustible substance. Now see, as you know that for the combustion process, now combustion means what? A burn, anything. Okay, so for that burning process, presence of a combustible substance very important. Okay, so the first condition is the combustible substance. See, the presence of combustible substance like paper, clothes, wood, LPG and petrol are necessary for the combustion to take place. So in this condition is very essential. So for burning anything, so we need that particular substance should be combustible. Okay, the presence of combustible substance very important. See, as you know that the stone is a non-combustible substance. Okay, but even though if you will try to ignite the stone, it will ignite, it will burn. No, because it is not possible, because it is a non-combustible substance. So for the combustion process, the presence of combustible substance are important. Okay, so this is the first condition for combustion. Now see, the next which is the condition, see, the supporter of combustion. Now supporter of combustion, see, in the last lecture we have discussed about the rapid combustion. Okay, so there are some combustible substance, okay, to burn them, for burning process they need a external support, they need a support to burn. And as well as the for combustion process, very important, very essential, that is for oxygen. Okay, you know that the property of oxygen, what is the property of oxygen? Oxygen support burning, okay, but it does not burn itself. So for the burning process, for combustion process, oxygen is very essential. So for combustion, very important, that is of oxygen. See, the combustion is a chemical reaction. Now we everyone know here the chemical reaction occurs. So chemical reaction between a combustible substance and oxygen. Now for example, why it is a chemical reaction? See, in the last time physical and chemical changes also we have done so many times practical, that is a magnesium rebar. So now magnesium rebar is a combustible substance, just I am giving you this example. Okay, magnesium rebar is a combustible substance. So when it burn, so for burning process what is necessary? This oxygen is very important for the burning process. So this magnesium rebar burn with oxygen and to produce a light, okay, that flame, you know that is a white flame, it produces a light and heat. So this is the chemical reaction. Now how this reaction takes place? See, magnesium is what? Mg. Okay, when this magnesium, see, for burning process we know that oxygen is important, so this magnesium react with the oxygen and form of magnesium oxide. Okay, so this is the chemical reaction. So for the support of combustion, so combustion is a chemical reaction. Now do you understand about how it is a chemical reaction? It is a chemical reaction between a combustible substance. Now this is a combustible substance and this one is a oxygen to produce heat, light, etc. So for the combustion, very important, that is of oxygen is very necessary. See, in whenever you were in fourth and fifth standard, that time also we have done the practical, that is what one candle, okay, and if you will put a inverted glass on that candle, after some time what it extinguish, okay. Why is so? Because it stop to supply the oxygen, okay, whatever the oxygens are present in that, so that much it is alive, but after that it extinguish, okay. See here, I have shown the picture also, and these activities so many times we have done. So for in this experiment it is true that for the burning process, for the combustion, oxygen is a very essential. Without oxygen any substance will not burn, okay. So this is our second condition, that is a supporter of combustion. Do you understand it? Okay, now see the next third one point, that is a tipping of initial temperature. Now see this initial temperature, it is a new point for you. So what is this initial temperature means? See, the lowest temperature to which a substance must be heated, the lowest temperature substance must be heated to catch fire and start burning it is called as a initial temperature. Now you know that some substances are there, they need a external support to burn. For example, lighter, matchsticks, they need, because this paper, okay, paper does not burn itself, okay, they need external support. So their ignition temperature is different. All the combustible substance, their ignition temperature is different. Ignition temperature means what? At the lowest temperature it start burning. Now for example, a white phosphorus, see, white phosphorus, it start burning when it come contact with air, okay. So it has a very low ignition temperature. So do you understand what is the meaning of ignition temperature? Ignition temperature means the lowest temperature to which a substance must be heated to catch fire and start burning, it is called as a ignition temperature, okay. So these are three conditions which are very essential for the combustion process, okay. So these three conditions, after this lecture just write down this all the points in your chemistry notebook, okay. See, some points, that is I have taken some extra, maybe you will not get in your textbook also. So whatever I am writing on the board, after the lecture you just write down in your chemistry notebook. So these three conditions are very essential for the combustion process. So again, the rapid revision we will do, that is the first condition is a combustible substance. So for the combustion, very important that the presence of combustible substances, for example paper, petrol, diesel, LPG, wood. And then second one, it is a very most essential condition, that is a supporter of combustion, okay. So combustion is a chemical reaction between a combustible substance and oxygen. So this oxygen is very essential for combustion. Without oxygen, combustion process will not occur, okay. Then they produce a heat. And the third one, it is the attainment of the initial temperature, means we have to reach to the ignition temperature, then only that particular substance will start burning. So every combustible substance, they have different ignition temperature. Ignition temperature means a lowest temperature, at that temperature it start burning. So white phosphorus, okay, white phosphorus has low ignition temperature because when it come contact with air, immediately it start burning. It does not need any support of any another support, okay. So maybe you have understand these all the three conditions which are necessary for the combustion, okay. So in the next period we will continue our next point. So today your homework is write this all the points in your chemistry notebook, as well as if you will get any information related to the same topic in another textbook, just write that all information in your chemistry notebook. So next point we will continue in our next lecture. Thank you.